Have got more than a little something for us here in Paris. The French just can't get enough of MN8. It's here the band first went gold. They've had one hit after another, and tonight they're going to be the first pop band ever to play at the top of the tower. And what a top place to launch Freaky, their second album. We caught up with the boys just before their live performance.
Hello.
How are you?
I didn't say hello to you. Sorry about that. What are you doing on the Eiffel Tower?
Doing a little showcase to show people different sides of MN8.
Did you feel a lot of pressure doing the second album because of the success of the first?
Well, personally for me, I saw a lot of pressure with the second album, basically because we had to find a way of growing up with the fans, you know, because you can easily be stuck in a rut where you'll be doing the same kind of pop stuff every time. And like, I think it was kind of a challenge, but in a way we had to like make these changes, like Tough to Follow and Dreaming are two like very diverse singles from what we were already doing before. I think they're more vocal, and there's a lot more stuff to come from MN8.
France, you're one of the biggest pop bands out here.
Do okay.
Why do you think you're so popular over here?
I think here they accept they accept for who you are, and because almost every show that we do in Paris, it has to be live. So they've seen and they heard a different kind of vocals and different kind of stuff. I mean, whereas in England and so on, it's mostly mine, and they're just categorized as another pop band or another boy band.
I heard that you said you preferred performing live to having sex. Is that true?
Yeah, but when you're on stage, it's like making love to everyone out there.
You see, basically, you can always have sex, yeah? But basically, it's only rare once in a while that we ever get to perform live. Whatever you want,
whatever you need, baby, you're gonna find it in me.
Dreaming is your new single. Tell me about it.
It's the first chance that people have chance to see MN8 vocally as they really are. It's a classy record, it's a vocal record, it's a very musical record. It's something that what you call boy bands wouldn't dream about doing these days.
How does it feel?
We need to do a sex symbol thing, because sex symbol is a novelty and that wears up. One minute you're on someone's
wall. Gee, man, I'm sorry. Look at these arms he's got.
No.
Fantastic arms. He's a sex symbol.
I'm looking good, but you know, sex symbols go up. We just want to have good music. Not really. We're not into the novelty sex symbol, having us on the wall thing. That's good. But that was last year. Right now, we want to make good music and be loved by everyone.
You can have good music, and you can look good, and you can be sex symbols.
Well, we'd have good music, and we might look good, but you call us sex symbols if you want.
Yeah. There we are.
We'd rather be called musicians.
But thanks for coming out here, you guys. Thank you very much.
Sexy musicians.
Ozone rocks. Ozone real. Ozone's the best, guys.
Fantastic. From where